wavers and YouTubians. For this video right here, I'm going to be teaching you guys actually how to cut your own hair personally without even having to even go to one of these high-priced barbers for one, which either get your hairline wrong and messed up, or in the other case, they just give you a nice haircut, but they give you a messed up lineup, or they probably give you a nice lineup, but a messed up haircut. So we're going to flip it. I want to teach you guys how to cut your own hair personally without having to go through all of them. A lot of people be actually scared to cut their own hair because they feel like they're going to mess up their own hairline, and they got to just wait for it to grow back in, or they're going to feel like they're going to mess up on something, an occasion where you can actually cut it on your own if you have the patience to do it. So, starting with today, we're going to have a wave journey. You just cut your own hair. So, right here, I have actually not even a waver anymore because I don't have any waves. I guess that's what y'all consider to be a waver, having waves 24/7. Right now, I guess I'm just nothing because I don't have anything. I want to show you guys how to, for one, cut your own waves inside of your head again, which is called the wave regenerator. That's what this is called. That's what you call this, me. The wave regenerator. But it's called the wave generator. Anyway, it's gonna be called the wave generator. So, for this one right here, for this episode, we're gonna do a wave generator. And this is what's gonna be called the wave generator. For one, to cut your own waves inside of your head. And for two, to even get your waves processed in the way you want to. And to get it cut down to a nice low length. And also, not to mess up a hairline. I'm guessing what's the title we should put for a hairline? To save a hairline or something like that. What y'all be saying? What's my guy? No, don't say LeBron James. That ain't right. What about you?
So, it's a girl?
Yeah, because I mean, right now, I ain't looking too good. So, I ain't a waiver. My junk all pushed. Everything messed
George
up.
George Jefferson.
George Jefferson. George Jefferson, not even. What about you? Anyway, the whole purpose of this thing is just to show you guys how to cut your own hair without even messing up and whatever, man. So we're gonna get the session started. Go ahead, Meech, cut up the camera.
Alright, so look, now we up in the bathroom, and now we about to get this stuff rolling, alright? Now, I just have a small eye issue, so I was just rubbing my eye, it was a bit irritable. But that's not gonna stop the show, by the keep running, alright? I'm gonna teach you guys how to actually cut your hair, and I wanna actually show you guys a little walk through it, okay? So, first off, when you actually begin to cut your hair, if you have 360 waves, make sure you comb in your wave pattern first, because some people, what they tend to do is, they just wanna go in and they wanna cut. And it's not that easy to just cut, because sometimes your cutting may not give you the nice wavy look that you really want to, right? So, if you want a smooth type of wave cut, then just actually cut it up so you don't have to worry about one. And so you just cut, you see, everything is running smoothly, and all of that. But when you do that, it actually preps your wave connection. I'm not saying that it gives you a full wave connection, but it helps assist you on a wave connection before actually going through with that. And also, it helps you spread your wave just a little bit more, okay? So, for me, I want to comb it out because I have waves now, so I'm not going to, I already did that. So, I want to actually comb it out and see what guard I'm going to need. It's called guard seeking. You want to see what guard matches you. Now, people say, oh, it's hard to cut your hair. A guard is no different than this, okay? A guard is no different from this. A guard, in other words, is just a comb. That's all a guard is. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through and we're going to see what guards actually fits my hair. Because not every guard fits your hair. You just need to put a guard on your head and expect what to cut, right? So you're going to need an actual guard to really choose what's going to actually go specifically for your hair. Okay? We're going to analyze some of these guards. Okay? We're going to analyze some of these guards, okay? And see which one fits us best. I'll call this back out. Okay. This one, people would choose a guard like this. You don't want to choose like, because my hair is not authorized for that. As you can see, it's not going to really cut my hair. You can see it's barely getting to my hair. It's cutting the hair, of course, but you really want a nice cut. This is not going to do it. My hair is not this wild. Okay? So we're going to say, meh, you're not going to go with this guard, okay? Guard number two. You can say this, wow. Right here, you got the 80s afro. Look. And that's not really gonna cut through because you're still trying to get those waves to put your hair, right? So that one is not authorized. Now let's get into some more better ones. Somewhat, right? Somewhat getting closer to the hair. We're getting closer and closer. This one is pretty nice, right? Bam. Bingo. This one is kind of shifty, but this is the way the guard is actually curved. This is the way it's actually designed. Now look at this one. So I was actually getting to my hair. I don't know if you guys can see. You see that actually the guard is actually in my hair. All of the teeth is in my hair. It's kind of like a comb. I want to actually comb this out. Look at this. Can I actually comb? Look at that. So you want a guard right here that's authorized for your hair, right? So now we found our guard. Man, this is the guard that we want, right? This is the specific guard that we want. We want that guard. Okay. I'm going to take this out on here. I'm going to comb it back down because I just want to show you guys that just for a quick, show, just to show you guys what I'm talking about. So my hair is not that wild for me to actually, you know, it's wild, but it's not that wild where I can't even show you guys. So that's why I was able to show you guys with that, okay? So they're gonna plug up our guards, and we're gonna actually show you guys how to go about doing this for part two. Now, some wavers actually tend to not want to tell you the secrets of how they get the job done. Some of them like to hold it back, the wave secrets and everything. Hey, who you kidding? You messing with the phenomenon right now. So you know what I want to do? You know I want to tell you my secrets and everything I do to get this job done today live, so you guys can actually go about doing this and get it done yourself, right? Okay, so I'm using fast feeders. Very good one. If you're a barber, you really love the fast feeders. Fast feeders really help you get the hair done, where you fade your hair down, up out of your quick cash. But fast feeders pretty good. Made by the group called, I guess the company called Oster. I'm not sure about the group. I really don't go off group names. I really don't go off name brand, this, that. I don't know this name brand. I know that Papa Waver had purchased it. You let me browse it, but you can actually, for the fast feeders, some people actually attempt to get in the name brand, like an Andes or, it's a marker. You got Andes and different kind, but not all of them suits your hair well. Not all of them does that. So you gotta actually make sure you get the ones that suit you. I actually tried out the fast feeders. Fast feeders are pretty good. I'm gonna show you guys how to actually place your guard on to the clippers properly. I never make this mistake again, but I was in a wave session with Papa Wave, and actually, I let him cut my hair, but the guards was not properly placed on it to the clippers. So the guards was halfway on the clippers, and as you know, the guards popped off. And I looked to the ground. And of course, the guards bounced off the floor. Before I knew it, the guards went from, and the clippers went from to, once I realized that the guard was on the floor, and I had patches everywhere in the back of my head. So make sure you guys placing your guards correctly to your clippers, okay? So how you go about doing this, start from the top. See, these are gonna have like these little trays, like these little dish trays and stuff. Some of them come with like these little trays inside, some of them don't. But actually, you can do it, you place it on here, top from the top, and it easy, you hear a click. You hear a click. See that? I'm sure you did it. It's obvious that it's on there. Okay. Place it on there, you can see it. Probably looking at it from the camera. Okay, there it go. And then once you clip it on there, so I was up a little bit, this is how they can see. You can clip it on there and it can be like this. You think you put it right, make sure you carefully slide it because you don't want to break your teeth neither. And they give you an uneven cut, so make sure you slide it slowly. Make sure you slide it slowly. Okay, now we got it on there, right? Now, while you're on there, you have to adjust these right here. The inside to the actual clipper's teeth. So you can adjust that by moving this right here. Little levy part, that's to move it, stuff like that. But by me as you having this, I don't want to start off with a low one. My hair is not that high, but it's pretty much high enough that I don't want to actually cause myself any pain while I start cutting. So I want to start off with a little bit. I want to push it a little bit far back like this. That's how that feels. Yeah, you can get something done with this. Most definitely, you can get something done with this. Now, some wavers actually tend to not want to tell you the secrets of how they get the job done. Some of them like to hold it back, the wave secrets and everything. Man, who you kidding? You messing with the phenomenon right now. So, you know what I want to do? You know I want to tell you my secrets and everything I do to get this job done today live, so you guys can actually go about doing this and get it done yourself, right? Okay, so I'm using fast feeders. Very good one. If you're a barber, you really love the fast feeders. Fast feeders really help get the hair done, where you fade your hair down, up out of your quick cash. But fast feeders pretty good. It's made by the group called, I guess the company's called Oster. I'm not sure about the group. I really don't go off group names. I really don't go off name brand, this, that. I don't know this name brand. I know that Papa Waver had purchased it. He let me browse it, but you can actually, for the fast feeders, some people actually, attempt to get the name brand, like an Andy's or, it's a Martha. You got Andy's and different kinds, but not all of them suit your hair as well. Not all of them does that. So you gotta actually make sure you get the one that suits you. I actually tried out the fast feeders. The fast feeders are pretty good. I wanna show you guys how to actually place your guard on to the clippers properly. I never make this mistake again, but, I was in a wave session with Papa Wave, and actually, I let him cut my hair, but the guards were not properly placed on into the clippers. So the guards was halfway on the clippers, and as you know, the guards popped off. And then I looked to the ground. Of course, the guards bounced off the floor. Before I knew it, the guards went from the clippers went from to. So I realized that the guard was on the floor. I had patches everywhere in the back of my head, so make sure you guys place them your guards correctly to your clips, okay? So, how you go about doing this, start from the top. You can see, these are here have like these little trays, like these little dish trays on the side. Some of them come with like these little trays on the side, some of them don't. But after you do it, you place it on here, start from the top, and then easy, you hear a click. You hear a click. Yeah. We did it. It's obvious that it's on there. Okay. Place it on there. Put the tip. Or looking at the camera. Okay, there it goes. And then once you clip it on there, so I was up a little bit. That's how to see. You can clip it on there and it can be like this. If you think you put it right, make sure you carefully slide it because you don't want to break your teeth near it. And they give you an uneven cut, so make sure you slide it slowly. Make sure you slide it slowly. Okay. I got it on there, right? Now, while you're on there, you guys, you have to adjust these right here. The inside to the actual clipper's teeth. So you can adjust that by moving this right here, a little levy for it, that's move it, stuff like that. But by me actually having this, I don't want to start off with a low one. So my hair is not that high, but it's pretty much high enough that I don't want to actually cause myself any pain while I start cutting. So I want to start off with a little bit high. I want to push it a little bit far back like this. That's how that feels. Yeah, we can get something down with this. Most
definitely, we can get something down with this. Now, I tell you, wavers, when you actually cut your hair, you're not going there freehand, as you see on what? On the mirror, right? Always have a mirror on hand. Never go in there freehand and try to cut your own hair. Otherwise, bad news bears, alright? So, well, as you can see, I have a mirror. The good part is, I can actually show you guys by. Somebody told me that was called a tri mirror or something like that, so I'm assuming it's called a tri mirror. I have one mirror to the side, one mirror behind me. I have another mirror right here, okay? So I want to show you guys at all point of angles. As you can see, I can get all angles, view of my head, of how to actually cut my hair properly, okay? So we're going to start, but I want to show you guys the top first, which is the easiest part of cutting my hair, all right? Okay, so let's get to it.
Danny, on the beat.
No, when you're just cutting your hair, when you're just cutting it like this, just know that when you're cutting your hair, it's just like brushing your hair. It's not like it's a hard part to it. You're still cutting it in a pattern-like form. So it's not like you're just cutting it any kind of way. No, you're cutting it as if you were brushing your hair. That's all it is. All that there is to it. So you know you brush your hair forward, right? You're not going to go this way. You're going to go straight down the middle, as if you were brushing your hair. Right? That you got that side because you're going to go over your hair a couple times. The barber, they just go over your hair one time to get your body, they have some of the customers. But you have the time and patience, right? It's just like brushing your hair. Just like brushing. And as you can see, I'm a waver again. See? I'm never out the game, baby. You know what I'm saying? I just fall up a couple times just to show you guys by example. I do it on purpose. Sometimes I don't. I'll be honest. See? Not like George Jeffy, you know? Look, front down,
this gone, that gone. Look, the rest over there. Right? So you see, the front is now complete. Well, it's not completely completed, but I'm just showing you guys what I mean by the front. You can see, it's pretty much complete. I mean, you can go and go over it. You can always cut over it a couple of times just to make sure you got it. Like I said, just like brushing your hair. You brush your hair forward, right? You go over the front. And make sure you start from the crown, because you start from the crown when you brush, right? Make sure you start from the crown up to the front. Now we're gonna move until the side, okay? Side angle. Well, I'm sure you guys can really see, so what I'm gonna do is, we're gonna go into another view, okay? Another view of this, and attacking the side.
Yeah, so I don't know if you guys can actually see my waves and how to wave, like I'm actually trying to show you guys, but, cause I don't know, like, I don't know if it's because of the lightning, but I'm trying to show you guys a good angle of it. I honestly think I cut it too low, trying to show you guys by example. I think I cut it too low by using this logo. I think it's a 0.8 or something like that. I think I kind of cut it a little bit too low, but I'm still going to show you guys. But I think I cut it a bit too low. Just a bit too low, but I'm still going to show you guys, okay? But like I said, let's move on to the size angle.
All right, so the size angle really different. So not much of a big of a difference, but it has something to do with hitting the angle, right? Brushing the side, we all know that you brush it from the crown all the way down towards the temple. We all know that as wavers. So what we're going to do is, we're not going to just cut randomly. We're not going to cut this way. We're just going to cut towards the temple. That's what we're going to do, okay? So pay attention. It's as if you were brushing. No hard stuff to it. Alright, so we're now going to do the right side. It's hard to really see my wave process right now, but that's not really the main focus. I want to do another video with my wave process, but it's hard to see that right now because I'm not actually giving myself the full potential cut as I keep going over it. But I just want to show you guys the basics of how to actually get this job done, alright? So now we're just going to cut this side and get this side up out of there. Okay? Same type of thing. We're just going to go. The same thing. Crown work. I'm not going to keep you guys here for long, okay? So you guys pretty much get the concept of how to do this size, okay? I want to jump straight to the back. Alright, so now since we got a nice little fresh cut that we got cut down to a low, because I cut it down, I believe I cut it down a little bit too low. Yeah, I got a nice little cut down left. Now I'm going to have to work for this one, but I cut it down low, and now we're going to go to our main important part, which is the lineup, okay? You really want to pay attention to this part. You have a lot of new growth that's going through. As you can see, it looks very edgy. We're gonna give it a nice little knead up edge up, okay? So, hold these in. These are Annie's, you know what I'm saying? Annie's, you know, kind of have a little small breakthrough through, but Annie's. All right, pretty loud. Annie's, you're gonna take your slow time with this. Okay, I'm not gonna be paying attention to this camera. I'm not trying to mess my hairline up. I'm gonna be looking directly at the mirror, okay? So, you guys can watch from here while I'm looking at the mirror. First thing first, I'm going to talk to you before I do it because I really don't want to talk. I really want to stay focused while I'm doing it. But you really want to work your way out to the front. Some people have two different strategies. Some people like to make their mark through the middle first. And some people like to start in the corners first, okay? Me, I want to start through the middle first because I always have this little peak. This is something genetically that's in me, so I have this peak and stuff. So I want to get that done, okay? So let's get it started. Before I do this, try not to put pressure on the skin. Don't try to go very hard with it. Just trying to, because you want to, of course everybody want a neat lineup, but you don't want to go too sharp with it. You don't want to try to overdo something that's really not there, okay? Don't try to overdo your lineup. Just do what you can do that's right there, okay? And only thing you can do is cut the excess hair. That's all we're working for, excess hair. That's how you start off as a beginner. Start off with the excess. I see the little hairs hanging off. You already have a hairline. People naturally already have a hairline, okay? Unless you just don't have a hairline, period. But people naturally have a hairline. Only thing you're doing is following the excess here. As you can see, it's not the perfect line, but as you can see, it's some sort of trace. You know what I'm saying? As you can see, and you're just going through, and you're gonna pick off the small line. You're not gonna actually cut that. You're not gonna start from here for a lineup, or you're not gonna start from here for a lineup. That's the only thing you're doing is pushing your hair back. Just start off with the excess here, okay? So let's do this. And no, when you get into the corners like these, when you get into the corners, try not to try to push it far back. Try not to push it too far back, but try to get a nice box off, okay? I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do that. Try to get a nice box off. It's actually harder for me to see this side, so I'm gonna operate from the other side. Harder for me to actually see this ain't at this angle, okay? I'm gonna push it from this side. Not that bad to be front, dude. Now you see how the peak is going. It's not all the way gone, but you can see I knocked off the excess here. That's all I did. Now look how it looks. As you can see, it still needs some tweaking, which you can go further too, but I'm just doing a basic tutorial for you guys to actually see. The only thing you're doing is just taking the excess here off. That's all you're doing. Now imagine if I actually took this and I actually try to mark it over. That would throw everything off. You already have a hairline, okay? Whether it's balanced or whether it's not unbalanced. And this right here is actually balanced itself. It's when you look, well, you're not looking at it the way I'm looking at it, but it's actually here that needs to actually grow in from that side of it. So it's still a nice line, okay, for the front. I'm done with the front. I'm not going to move any further except just cut the little front hair. So I'm saying that's already growing my forehead, okay? Now for the side, so you want to get a nice little box on, but be careful, because this part can be very dangerous. Okay, it's hard for me to see. Nice view. There we go. I got a nice box. See that box? See here? All I do is only thing I did to take that to get that box. I easily pressed this side right here up. Now I'm not pressing it hard like trying to indent something. Just trying to indent something on my head. No. Just take it. And just lightly press it up against where you see the excess here, and it's going to cut itself. It's doing it itself. It's automatic. It's going to cut itself. You're just guiding it. That's all you're doing. So I did that. That went directly up near these here. That's all I did, okay? Now we're going to continue. Now we're going to go through this side. This excess here. Not bad. I'm actually keeping my sideburns there, so I'm actually trying to grow a beard in. I'm like, hey, I got a mustache here. So far, you guys can't see it because it's too much brightness, but I'm actually trying to grow my facial hair, so I'm going to start just keep going over it. I'm going to do this other side. Yeah. You see, it's not that bad. Not that far off. This one's a bit farther off, just a little bit off, because I had came off a taper with this one. So I didn't let this grow farther back in. But as you can see, I didn't do anything very risky this time. Understand? That was my little taper cut. As you see, I didn't go exactly hard with it. They're doing an excess hair. People try to go off the back, like the back of the hair is hard. Back of the hair is not hard. If you have a mirror, you are able to do the back of your head. I want to show you how you do that, okay? So let me give you a nice little view of how I did the front of my head. I'll give you a nice little view. This is how the front of my head looks. Kind of a couple of hair shit on my hair thing on my camera. But as you can see, it looks pretty nice, okay? Look pretty nice. I can't edge it up more. I want to edge it up more after I record, but I'm showing you guys what I'm talking about. You didn't see me do anything fancy, anything spectacular. You see me go over the assets here, which I'm going to do. I'm going to try to do a little bit more after I get off the camera, but I'm showing you guys just the basic of how to get stuff done just in a basic way without trying to go to your barber. All right, so basically, the back is just like the front. That's all it is. The back is just like the front. You don't have to go all crazy and ridiculous, but I just did one side of the back. As you can see, it kind of looks a little bit more sharp here. I really didn't cut the actual hair. However, what I did do was I just followed and I just traced the actual line, because you already have a hairline. Just cut off the excess hair. Just get it into that perfect form that you want it to. Okay? So that's all you're pretty much doing. And try not to do too much of the ear. If you really don't know how to do too much of the ear, try not to do it like me right now. I'm not very skillful on the ear. I usually mess up every single time. So I'm not going to try that mark. But as you can see, the ear already has its own line. So that being said, we're gonna go ahead and wrap it up. And there you go, you did it. You cut your own hair. You did that. Look how neat I look. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna say I'm the waviest right now, Chris. I believe I kind of made a couple errors in this. However, like I said, I'm just glad I actually accomplished the goal of actually showing you guys. So I'm gonna actually get this wavy thing back up. I'm still gonna let you guys see it. I'm pretty proud of how it looks after the cut. I'm sure you guys get the concept of what I'm talking about. I hope you guys get the concept of what I'm talking about. If not, it's a little bit back here at home. But I'm glad that you guys were able to actually stay tuned with your boy Phenomena and learn some more new things about that. And when I was growing up, after getting a haircut, we knew what time it was. Alcohol time. And sadly, after the haircut, growing up, we knew what time it was. The worst part of the haircut, now is receiving the alcohol burn. Burning. 91% burning sensation. We had a good time together. We learned how to cut your own personal hair without making your barber man that barely can do a hairline nor cut the hair rich anymore. And we did it ourselves, right? And we learned ourselves. And that's the good part, right? So if you love this video, if you really enjoyed having fun with your boy Phenomena making this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Make sure you like. Make sure you do all of that. Like I said, because no matter what, I still want to always be here for you guys to show you guys what you guys really need, what I feel like was really essential, and what's upcoming and what's new. What I feel like what you guys really need to know that's up in the trend right now, and what has been forgotten in the trend. So, thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you guys for viewing. You know how we do it? Most of all, never stop brushing. out.